they all have the same effect. They are marketed differently as being, you know, sedatives or anti-anxiety medications, but all of them have the same five properties. So they all are hypnotics, meaning they induce sleep. They're all anxiolytics, meaning they help to reduce anxiety, but they're also amnesics, so they sort of impede that memory consolidation process. They're all anticonvulsants, and they're all muscle relaxants. They work by enhancing the brain's natural calming neurotransmitter, which is GABA, and they increase its effects in the brain. GABA is the brain's main inhibitory neurotransmitter. So neurotransmitters are the chemical messages in the brain. The most common ones that people would be familiar with are things like dopamine and serotonin. But GABA is the main inhibitory one. So this is the main neurotransmitter that calms the brain down and slows down the processing. And what a benzo does, it actually binds to the site that unlocks the door for a GABA to get into a cell, into a brain cell, and take effect. So they really increase the effects of our brain's natural calming neurotransmitter. And sometimes actually shut down some of those cells altogether. So they have quite a powerful effect in the brain. Obviously some benzos more than others are stronger and might be more sedating or might have better anxiolytic effects. But as I said, all benzos have those same properties.